Hey y'all. Come on in. We have a good one today. I'll give y'all a moment to get in here. Hope all is well. It's such a beautiful day today. The sun is out. The birds are chirping. The butterflies are flying around. Such a wonderful day. Hi, welcome, welcome. Take a moment for people to get in. Come on, y'all. Let's see. Hey, welcome. So I'm gonna hop right in. This video is Be Choosey with Your Attention. In a couple different factors inspired me to make this video. I guess the main one being all the stuff that's going on right now in our world. Hey y'all, peace and love. There's a lot of stuff going on in our world right now in the matrix with the collective. Hey, hello. People are getting told on. Politicians getting in trouble. The major players in our world are being called out for doing suspect things. And it's a beautiful time to be alive. There's a lot of things going on that may be stressing you out. But if you focus on the fact that you are living in such a magnificent time right now, you will be able to see that. To see that, wow, things are really changing and moving, and this is the healing and purging time that we all really need as a collective. You know, we need this time to cleanse and get rid of, you know, the cancer on the planet. That's what they call it. So I want to encourage y'all to be really choosy with what you're paying attention to, especially, you know, as far as the news, okay? Because certain things are put out in the news in order to suck up your energy and your consciousness and your power, okay? And like, how do they do that? Well, everything is energy, you know? Everything is energy. So what you're paying attention to is you're feeding it. You're loaning yourself out. You're sharing yourself. And it's an exchange that's taking place whether you realize it or not. So you have to be careful of that. Nowadays, and you notice it's a cycle, it's a pattern that they, when they put out certain news, like all the shootings, it was a pattern. Every month during a certain day or during a certain week, they'd start talking about all these shootings or, you know, all these arrests or all this gang violence and all of this, and you're paying attention to it, and it's just, it's becoming you. It's streaming in the back of your mind and your subconscious. It's like, yeah, all this stuff is going on. I'm kind of nervous, I'm kind of scared. And that is the purpose, right? To inspire this fear state in you. Because if you're in a fear state, you cannot be living in your heart chakra. They can't, they don't exist together. So if you, when you're in a constant fear state, you're feeding your energy to these entities that require it. Because, you know, I say in my other videos, there are entities out here that do not have souls, okay? There are entities out here who are not creators. We are creators. And that is why our consciousness is being siphoned. This is why certain things are put on the news for us to watch, okay? This is why certain celebrities and certain music artists are being used to put out certain messages. It's to keep you in that loop. Hi, peace and love. Welcome, y'all. It's to keep you in that loop, that fear state loop, that doubt loop, that worry loop, the jealousy. Like, oh, I'm not as cute as her, or my body don't look like that, or I don't make as much money as he does, or my dog isn't as cool as his dog. It's this program. It's this cycle that keeps floating and floating. And if you do put on the TV, pay attention to what you're watching because you'll see it. Nowadays, we're in this time where everything and everyone is going to tell on themselves. Every single thing and everyone is going to be fully transparent for you, especially if you're awakened, especially if you've been practicing your discernment and connecting with self and connecting with your soul. You'll be able to tell things a mile away, like, look at that. That's a fear state. All right? That's a jealousy state. That's a hate state. That's anger. Whatever. That's your projection. You'll be able to recognize when people are projecting at you, or if it's truth, or if your energy is being siphoned from you. And a lot of y'all are really conscious of what's going on. Like, you know that if you're having the best day of your life and you tell maybe your friend, and then they're just dry. They're just dry as hell. They can't congratulate you. Or as soon as you finish saying what you're saying, they talk about all this negative stuff that's in their lives. It's because, and a lot of them aren't even hating. A lot of them aren't even conscious of what they're doing. A lot of times, it's these entities and these beings that have attached to them. It's these spirits that have attached to them that just, that are jealous and angry because you can create this reality for yourself, or you can manifest, or you experience so much love in your life because you found so much love for yourself. You know, and you can notice, like, sometimes you have to let certain people go. Sometimes you have to realize when you need to detach from certain things. So I really want to encourage y'all to be choosy. Be choosy with your relationships, the people who want to get close to you. Not everybody deserves your attention, okay? And that may sound harsh. You know, I promote so much, walk with love and treat everybody with love, but really, not everybody deserves your best love. Everybody deserves, you know, for you to sprinkle a little heart chakra energy on them, but not everybody deserves to get your ultimate best in all of you in that way. You deserve all of you. You deserve your ultimate best. So be choosy with the people you select to share a relationship with you. Be really choosy on that. Pay attention to your friends. And I keep emphasizing that now is the time to do this because shifts are happening. Like, there's pole shifts. There's planetary shifts. Like, things are happening on a cosmic spiritual level that are intense. Okay? So you're creating your life. You're creating the life that you want for yourself. And you want to make sure it's the best life. And it has the best people. And it's full of abundance for you. Because if it's not, your life is going to reflect that. It's going to show you, like, oh, I made a mistake right there. Or, oops, I shouldn't have got too close to that person because then all 2511 demons is circling around me. I just feel all this energy and I can't break out of it. So you want to use your discernment. You want to be choosy first. Be real selective and not care about letting people go. And not care about, you know, not accepting an invitation to something. Don't care. You know, about it. Be really firm in yourself and what you want for yourself. What else? I mentioned the music again. Like, I love music. I love all music. I find something cool about trap, and I find something transcendent about jazz and classical. I like reggae. I like all music. But nowadays, I've been noticing, and for quite a while, the music is real toxic. The music is real gutter. It's like it's really low vibrational music, so I want you to pay attention to that as well. And I feel it too. Some days I like a little trap beat, and other days I'm like, ugh, I can't. Like, my mind won't allow me to do that. So I want you to be choosy with your music. And everything with your food. Lately my body has been saying just eat raw. So I've been eating raw and enjoying it. Like, I've never enjoyed raw foods before. Like, right now I'm like, ooh, I have a salad I'm about to make. I can't wait. And that's me being choosy with that. Being choosy with what I'm putting in my body because my soul is saying, pay attention to what you're putting in your body right now. There's so many frequencies flowing right now. There's so many beautiful, divine entities trying to get in contact with us. And I know for a fact that's one of the main reasons why I'm being called to be selective with what I'm putting in my body and who I'm being around. Because you don't want to hinder any uploads or downloads that you receive from these energies. You don't want to block them. So if you feel in your soul that, look, I really need to let go of this French fries, or I really need to let go of this malt liquor, like, you feel it in your soul, let it go. Because there are energies and vibrations that want to activate you, that want to contact you. And it can be hard for them to do that if you're not in a state of cleanliness within yourself, within your mind, your spirit, and your physical. So I suggest fasting. Like, I did 2 4-day fasts within 2 weeks. And now, like, my body is kind of like, yeah, I think I need another fast. It's like my soul is saying, we really want you to clean up, because the information and the messages that you'll be receiving, it's a requirement that you're clear. So I want to tell y'all to be mindful of that too. If you feel any inclinations to let things go with your food, with your friends, with your drink, with your any activities, let it go. And the sooner you let it go, the better. And please understand and believe that, know that things will be replaced with so much more, like so much more. It's like donating $1 to somebody and realizing that you're gonna get $10 back, or you're gonna get $100 back. And not to say that's the reason why you should lend out money or your currency, but just understand that it's reciprocity, right? You give and you take. This whole reality we live in is an exchange. What are you exchanging? What are you receiving? So that's why I really want you guys to be choosy with your attention, okay? Man, I keep hearing this, the news, the media. Be careful of the media, y'all. Like, y'all already know they be lying. Like, there be people I'm in contact with and they be like, yeah, that shit wasn't even on the news. Or it was on the news, but it wasn't even that deep. So really pay attention to that. Know that everything that you see and that you hear, it plays in your subconscious. It plays on like a back screen. It attaches to you. It becomes a hold of you, or it takes a hold of you. And you have no choice but to make it and pull it into your reality. And the people who are in charge of the media, they know this. It's a science. It's really simple. And you guys need to grasp this, because you're being used. You're being siphoned. You're being sucked dry. Your power is being stolen from you. But if you don't pay attention to something, it literally cannot exist. It's not in your realm of reality. It's not even there. You know what I'm saying? So I want to tell y'all that. This is going to be real quick. I have a bunch of work to do. Y'all who are waiting for your birth charts, please bear with me. They're coming soon, all right? I'll send you emails. And those who want to schedule time with me, check out the website, TiaraSharde.com. And I keep pushing that because there's a lot of y'all that contact me, but there's more who want to reach out and you don't. And that's okay when you're ready. And not even just with me. I feel like there's so many people who need assistance and they want to share, and they're feeling like they can't reach out or ask for help. And please know that you can. Even if you don't talk to me, talk to somebody else that you resonate with. Meditate, talk with your ancestors and your spirit guides. Like, they are waiting. Like, my life changed when I connected to my ancestors in the spirit world in that way, and I started talking with them. Like, everything changed. It's like having the backup, right? So I have these feelings, these thoughts, I hear these things, and then I receive a file on it. Like, I receive the paperwork, you know what I'm saying? Or like, my ancestors co-sign it. Like, you have that backing, you have that access to help. So call on that. They're waiting for you. They really are waiting for you. Like, even with friends and people that I've grown to love, like, the spirit world would like whisper to me, like, tell them this too. Oh, wait, come back. Tell them this, tell them don't forget that. Like, so I get that a lot. So I feel like that's why I'm telling y'all too. Like, there's a lot of y'all spirit guides and ancestors that wanna contact y'all. So that falls into line with being choosy with your attention too. Don't pay attention to the TV when you could be paying attention to your spiritual entourage, who really got your back and they trying to help you ascend as efficiently as possible without jumping over major hurdles or hurting yourself or other people. So that's all I wanted to say. Thank y'all for joining me. This will be on my YouTube channel, Nature Girl Neo. Again, I'll start going live on my YouTube channel. Follow me on Instagram, Nature Girl Neo. Again, the website, TiaraSharde.com. And I gotta get to work, y'all, so after I eat this salad. Because my soul is telling me, baby, eat that salad. So that's what I'm gonna do. And I hope y'all do the same. I hope y'all are loving up on yourself and you're enjoying your day and you're showing yourself the best possible love you can. And I send y'all love as well. So peace and love. Mwah. Bye.